Welcome in this second tutorial about Blender. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to render your image and how to move in the viewport. When we start Blender, Blender opens a default scene, and this is the default scene with a cube. And here we see a camera and here we see a lamp. And the thing in Blender is that you can adjust your default scene according to your needs, but I'm going to use the default scene in Blender. And what we see here is actually some kind of virtual world. We can control light, camera, materials, we can control everything in this virtual world. But what we see here is not the final result. The process of translating what we see here in the viewport into an actual image or animation is called rendering. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to render this scene, and the image we'll see is actually the image as the camera sees our object. So we can move around here, but it doesn't affect how the image looks because we render via a camera. So here on the top, you see the render menu, and then you can choose render image. You can also press F12. If I press this, you see a rendered cube. This is the cube the camera sees. You also see the calculations for shadow are done, lightning, and this is a very sharp image. If you want to close this window, you can press Escape, or you can just close the window with your mouse. When I select things, I select them with my left mouse button. And as you can see on the left side of the screen here, you see exactly what I'm doing and what I click with my mouse and when I press a certain key. This is an advantage because then you see what I'm doing, and sometimes I might forget to tell what button I've pressed, so you can see it over there. We're now continue with showing you around all the sections of this screen. So this is our main view, and we have certain operations here like moving, rotating, and scaling. Here you can move around the object, see it from the top side, bottom side, left side, etc. At the bottom here, we have a timeline. This blue kind of rectangle indicates that we're in frame number one. When we make animations, we have several frames, and these frames in sequence is an animation. So here you see that we have an animation from frame 1 to frame 250. On the top right here, you see our object explorer. Here you see our camera, our cube, and our light. So when you have a lot of objects, you can quickly find it over here. Here you see on the bottom right the properties of what I've selected. So in this case, a light, but when I select my cube, you see the dimensions of the cube. Here there are a lot of more kind of panels you can open, like the material, or for example, the render settings. And if you select the camera, there's also the camera settings. In future tutorials, I'll explain more of this. Here on the top right, you see some kind of thing where you can choose between top, the left, and the front view. So you can rotate around. If you drag your mouse over here, you'll see that when you drag, you can rotate around the center, and you can see it from different angles, which is very useful when you're modeling your 3D object. But if I press here on the X, you see here a shortcut, numpad 3. And the numpad is the right side of your keyboard with all the numbers. So if I press this 3, you see I switch immediately to the right view. If I press 8, for example, I move upwards, I can rotate upwards. And when I press the 7, you see top, the 9 is bottom. And you might figure out how do you know this? Well, here on the top left, it says bottom orthographic. So when I press the 1, I have the front orthographic, etc. But here is also a view menu. And in the view menu, you have here the viewpoints And there you can also select exactly what you want. So if I press here front, you see the front view. But if I say, for example, back, then you see it's rotating to the back. If I want to see my 3D view again, I can just drag and I can move it any way I want. Dragging here all the time can be quite annoying. So therefore, there's a faster way to do this. If you hold down your center mouse button and you start moving, you can do exactly the same. If you don't have a third mouse button, then you can use the trackpad. And then you have to use two fingers on the trackpad to rotate your screen. You can also move your view, and that's what you do with holding the shift button and using the center mouse button, the middle mouse button, and move from left to right, up, down. Then you can move your view around. You can also zoom in and zoom out by using the scroll wheel. So now I'm scrolling up and I zoom in, and I'm scrolling down and I zoom out. You can do the same on your trackpad by pinching your fingers like you do on a smartphone. Here on the right side, you see all these operations I told you about. So if you hold down your left mouse button on the zoom and you move your mouse, then you're zooming in and out. If you use the hand, you can grab the object, or not the object, the view, and move it around. And if you press the camera, you can see what the camera sees. And if you press it again, you go back to the 3D view. This last icon switches between perspective and orthographic projection. We're now in perspective view, but when I click again, now we're in orthographic view where there's no perspective. This sometimes is useful when you're making isometric graphics. I click again to make it perspective. So as you can see, you can switch between a lot of views and move around in your viewport. This is what you're going to do a lot when you're designing in 3D. So now you know how to render what the camera sees and how to move around in the viewport. This is some of the basic operations you need to create very cool things in Blender. In the next episode, I'm going to explain you how to move, rotate, and scale objects. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments, and in the description of this video, you find additional information about this tutorial. I see you in the next video.